Okay, you guys, it cut off on me. I don't know where I left off, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you these signs. There we go. You see them? See them? Don't they look good? And like I said, I'm old school, so I use a fork, okay, to flip them. I'm gonna go ahead and flip them again because I don't want them to burn. You see that? Go ahead and flip them again. I want them to cook perfectly. Oh, okay. Be careful. Be careful, because this is hot grease, you guys, when you're using a fork, okay? There we go. Look at them. But they look perfect. Now, when it's time to pull them out, I will use a spatula to grab them and pull them on out of there, okay? Don't they look good? Okay. So that's my Simon Croquettes, you guys. And I love Simon Croquettes. My family does too. And like I said, it's a quick meal. So it's something I can fix real quick and get my grandson in the bed. His dad's gone to work. So I have to take care of him once his dad goes to work. Hold on a moment. I'm getting ready to pull these babies out. Hold on. Let me stand this up, okay? Getting ready to pull them out.
Like I said, it doesn't take time to cook that long. So this ain't gonna work. I need something a little bit more steadier than that. Here we go.
This right here, okay?
This is gonna pick them up, pull them on out of there.
See those? Let's see if y'all can see them. Hold on.
Let me get these other ones in here. I'm gonna put three in that one.
So let me let you guys look at my Simon Croquettes, okay? There they go. There they go. There we go. Don't they look good? Yeah, they look good. So I have these. See that? And I'm gonna go ahead. Like I said, as soon as you put them in there, it doesn't take. Remember, this is fish and it's Simon Croquettes. So that you kind of mushed up and got it prepared to go into the skillet. Look at that. Look at these. Okay. So I was looking at, you know, I look at a lot of feeds, right? And I was looking at this particular feed. And this guy is seeing a therapist who's been through so much in relationships. He's a young guy. He's about the age of my kids, you know? And his therapist, he was telling his therapist, he said, you know, when I have my highs, they're really highs. And then when I have my lows, they're really lows. And he said, I would like to find myself one day just in the middle, okay? So the psychologist told him this, and it made sense. He said, just remember this, when you're on a heart monitor, he said, it's always going up and down, up and down. He said, now, if it goes to the middle, that means you have flatlined. That means you're dead. He said, so what your highs and lows do, it reminds you that you're going to have high and lows. But the one thing you don't want to do is find yourself in the middle. where you're flat line, you know? And I thought, wow, you know, that really makes sense. Because we do have days where we're really up, up, up. And then we have other days when we're really down and depressed. I have those days. It may not seem like it, but I do. I do. Where I'm just depressed. And don't even know why sometimes. You just, it's just life, you know? But you got to remember, when life shoots you lemons, just make lemonade. Okay? Just make lemonade. So let's go look at these. Let's go look at these again. Let's look at them again. Here we go. Oh, yeah, they're looking good. So let's go ahead and flip these again. There we go. Yeah, look at them. There we go. Look at that. Don't that look good? Oh, my God. Look at that. Yeah, look at those. And I only have two more left. See how quick that meal was? The main thing is just putting everything together, you know? It's just putting everything together. But look at that. Look at that. So remember, you know, you're not going to always have good days. You're going to have some good days. You're going to have some bad days. But what you don't want to do is flatline. You don't want to be in the middle. You just want to just take each day as it comes. Because like I tell you, today is the first day of the rest of your life. So what you got to do is just make each day a good day. Okay? And, you know, come home. When you get out from work, come on, relax. Get you a glass of wine. Like me, I'm listening to some music and I'm cooking. That relaxes me. You know, you got to find your happy place. You know, happy place for me is cooking. Happy place for me is watching my family eat what I cook and watch them enjoy it. Okay? You just have to find your happy place. So you guys, I'm going to go ahead and end this live so I can feed my family. But remember, if you didn't have a good day, don't go messing with nobody's day. Okay? Today is the first day of the rest of your life. So just make it a good day. Okay? Like, share, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to hit that bell. And I'll see you on Friday when I'm doing my Jamaican shrimp. My husband been asking me for this all week. He went and bought everything I needed to fix this meal. So I don't have a choice. I have to prepare it for him. Okay? I'll see you guys in the kitchen. Make it a good day.